deep respect and admiration for people that grew up during the Great Depression. They always seem to have a sense of purpose, a sense of mission, in addition to the toughness and frugality that growing up in economic hardship develops. So today I'm going to talk to you about my grandmother, who I guess would be considered particularly salubrious. Try to get that in there. who probably had a better sense of mission than anybody I know. Now, I don't know a lot about her childhood. I know she grew up in the Great Depression in Minnesota. This particular story of where her life changed is something that happened when she was an adult. She had three children. My mother was the youngest. And one day, she was helping my grandfather, who was a carpenter, build a fence. Now, as anybody who's ever built a fence knows, the hardest part of building a fence is digging the post holes. And so on this day, my grandfather was using a motorized auger to dig these post holes. And it wasn't unusual back then to have a person stand on top of the auger or sit on top of the auger to give it more force to break through the hard ground. On this day, my grandmother was that person. And so as they were working, at some point her dress got caught in the auger, and the auger pulled her down, caught her arm, and literally yanked her arm off. Mm. At this point, she began screaming, running around, spurting blood out of the spot where her arm used to be. Naked. I know this because my aunt, who was 6 or 7 at the time, saw the whole thing happen, and so I've actually heard this story firsthand. Now, after she went to the hospital and started the healing process, my grandfather decided he was going to leave. So my grandmother became overnight, a crippled, unemployed, single mother of three. And because she couldn't pay her bills, she soon became a homeless, crippled, unemployed, single mother of three. Now, she was able to find help in the community and through her church and different organizations, and was able to kind of bounce from house to house with her family until she found a job. She got a job with a company called Lockheed Martin, and once she was able to scrimp and save enough, she was able to come up with a down payment for a house. So she bought a house in San Jose, California for $19,000. Now, she was actually able to raise her three kids to be productive members of society and retire. She lived 30 years past her retirement. She actually died last year. In her retirement, she developed a hobby, and it was something that came from her childhood when she was younger, but she started painting. And so she did all these paintings, and when she died, all of her heirs got to pillage her belongings, and so we each got some of these paintings, and I'll show you this painting here in a moment. This particular painting is a picture of a mission in California. It was actually the last painting she did. Wow. And the thing about this painting is she died before she could finish it. It's unfinished if you look, the trees aren't done. So I set this, this painting hangs in my office. If you ever come by my office, you'll see it directly across from my desk. And it's a reminder of my grandmother's unfinished mission. And whenever I am sitting there and struggling with something that I need to finish, and I'm coming up with excuses why I shouldn't, sometimes it might be, I wonder what so-and-so's doing on Facebook, or it might be something else. I get to look up at that picture and my grandmother's unfinished mission, and I realize that she didn't finish that mission because she died. And I get to ask myself, what's your excuse? My grandmother was a crippled, unemployed, homeless, single mother of three, and she was able to live a pretty full life. And if there's any excuse that I can come up with that compares with that, I can't think of one. And so I'd ask you too, whenever you're trying to complete your mission, what's your excuse? Thank you.
Minutes to write your comments for Brian, and then we'll go to our second.